you take your little boat and go across. I'll go get me a cab, and I'll be waiting on the other side for you.
Excuse me, I need a boat. I want to go across the river.
Excuse me, excuse me, excuse me.
You're gonna have to go faster than this, guys. I'm never gonna win.
For these two, the race is always on.
I don't know what he said.
But before they get to the finish line, let's catch up.
Look, Mom, no hanging!
Reality star Rob Mariano and monster trucker Dennis Anderson have used 53 ways.
Oh, yeah, we're making some time now.
To get from Los Angeles to Udaipur, India.
He's yawning.
On this leg of their India adventure, the guys will be traveling from Delhi to Calcutta.
Rob, are you sure you want to do this?
Don't be such a baby.
There's a monsoon festival to check out.
You look like a freaking fool, dude.
But it's really all about coming in first.
I'll reach you to the top. Let's do it.
No matter how you're traveling.
Coming home!
I hurt my ankle and my pride.
Rob Mariano and Dennis Anderson are circling the globe using 80 forms of transportation without repeating a single one. It's around the world in 80 ways.
You gotta be kidding me.
We're in the city of Delhi. With almost 17 million people, it's the second biggest in India and the eighth largest in the world.
Well, I thought it would be easier to find out where we're going, but everything looks the same.
Delhi has been Delhi for over 2,700 years. One of the results of this impressive longevity is the highest road density in India. That means a hell of a lot of traffic, and we're not just talking cars.
Look at this, right in the middle of town, look at these hogs rooting right in behind that white deal there. See it? Where are we going next?
I was thinking we'd go up to Calcutta. They have the monsoon festival. It signifies the start of the monsoon season.
So it's a party then?
It's a huge party.
I'm up for a party. After all of this, this on the side of my face, my hand, I need a party, buddy. Let's do it.
The boys need to catch a train from Delhi to Calcutta. But to get a ticket, they'll have to work for it.
Now, that's a man's load right there.
By hauling this wide load into town.
Got a little tractor, and I'm telling you, that is a bale of, I don't know what it is, if it's wheat straw, grass, if it's something to feed the cattle with, or if it's something to grind up for the people to eat.
Rob usually makes for the driver's seat, but he wisely hands over the reins to Dennis.
All right, I'll ride on top. You drive.
Okay. Be careful, Rob.
This country boy has been behind the wheel of a few tractors in his time.
Let's go!
Right, I'll be ready!
But tractoring on a North Carolina farm...
Dennis! Go! Go!
...is a little different than hitting the streets of Delhi.
Go! Go! Go!
Watch this power line.
We're gonna find second gear in that thing, or we're gonna putter along.
All right.
I thought you know how to drive that. It's neutral. You're killing the clutch.
I gotta go faster.
Yeah, this guy's out cold, sleeping.
Dude, this thing is way overloaded, Rob.
Dennis, watch out for the power lines.
Look at this. Here's one over here. Hey, yeah. Here's another one. You know, all we use our tractors for is farming, plowing the field. These guys, I can tell you right now, they get their money's worth out of a tractor here. They haul cargo with them, they plow fields with them, they grade with them, they haul sewage with them. These guys get it, they get the bang for their buck, and they use their tractors.
The world's first tractors came on the scene around 1850. They were basically steam engines on wheels. They're workhorses, but they're also playhorses. Tractor racing is a U.S. phenomenon. The U.S. Lawnmower Racing Association has sponsored races across the country. After 50-plus miles an hour, the modern version can really haul grass.
You better watch your head!
Okay, now. Wait. Stay on this side. We're jumping the trees.
All right, dude, I've got it.
We're going. Dennis, watch where you're going. Get on one side or the other.
I can't. I almost got to use the whole middle. Hey, how are we looking over there?
You got a line of traffic behind you.
I wish I had some mirrors on this thing. I can't see.
All right, how about now? Okay, now. No.
Damn. Rob.
Idiot.
The guys made it to the outskirts of Delhi.
Dennis, pull it over.
It's going to take a lot more skill than they've got to navigate its narrow streets.
Dennis, look at the traffic jam you caused.
I should have been blowing that.
Look at them mad. It was him.
Shut up. Come on, let's go. Hold on to the rope. Come on. Come on.
You got me?
Yes. Come on. Come on.
Okay, I got it.
You got it?
Yep. That was fun, huh?
Yeah, man, that was cool.
Dennis and Rob are in Delhi looking for the train station, but instead come across one of the most unusual ways of travel you'll find anywhere in the world.
What are they doing, man?
Excuse me, do you guys speak English? You speak English? How you doing? What are these guys doing?
The guy is going to the temple.
Go to the temple.
To thank God.
So it's a prayer.
Well, why don't they just walk? Why have they got to do that?
If you've ever heard the term holy roller, these worshipers are what it's referring to.
Holy moly, looks like you better have a wash machine to wash your clothes.
You think we could join them?
Yeah, you can.
It wouldn't be offensive or anything?
No.
You want to try it?
Are you serious, Rob?
Why not, dude? One in Rome. One in India.
When in India.
Do as an Indian.
What are you calling that? The crawl?
Just put off your shoes before you go like this.
We gotta take our shoes off?
Here, take them off.
God almighty. This is the last pair of clean socks I got. Rob, are you sure you wanna do this?
It's like the dirtiest place in the world.
She will take care of us.
Okay. These are expensive.
Those are kind of expensive. These really are expensive.
Come on, Dennis, let's do it.
They don't have them around here because they were made out of cowhide.
Ready? Try something new.
And then what do you do once you're straight out?
I don't know. You kind of walk a little ways. Then you have to go like this. Oh, show me an email. Oh, yo,
one, two, three.
No, you're not doing that.
I'm watching him. Three steps, pick it up, down.
One. Two, three.
Hindus regard the coconut as a symbol of the Lord Shiva and use it as an offering during prayer. Worshippers lay flat on their stomachs and nudge the coconut toward the temple as a gesture of deep respect for their deity.
One, two, three.
Holy rolling has all types of variations. Dennis and Rob do a combination of rolling, walking, and crawling to push a coconut toward the temple. Holy rolling is one of the more unusual ways to travel. There's one holy man who's been on a roll for the last 19 years. His name is Latan Baba, and he's rolled thousands of miles all across India. In 1994, he set a world record when he rolled 2,485 miles from Ratlam to a religious shrine in the city of Jammu. In all, he's rolled over 20,000 miles to promote world peace.
Dennis, what are you praying for?
That nobody sees me doing this. Am I doing it right?
Is that right?
All right, y'all ready? One, two, three, here we go. Put the coconut down, knees on the ground. Stretch out. Ooh. Woo! Yeah! Go get it. Put it back up there. Put it up. Yeah. Go up. Go that way. Yeah. Okay. Whew.
One, two, three, four. Oh, sorry.
Once Dennis and Rob get on a roll, it's not long before the competition heats up.
Hey, Dennis, I'll race you to the top.
Winner!
Come on, be respectful. Take your hat off, you're in a temple.
Jeez.
For holy rolling, every inch counts, and it certainly counts as a new way.
Even when you're praying, you're racing.
Well, if you got to the top first, you'd tell me you beat me. I just had to make sure that you
weren't. You didn't get to the top first, because look, here's the top right here on this tile.
Oh, you're gonna play that
game? Right there. This is it.
Oh, no, well, actually, this is it. This is higher. Oh, this is higher.
That's the rail, but this is the temple. Look, he's getting pissed at you. Don't climb on the rails, Rob. Serious.
Sorry. Okay, let's go.
Yeah, that's good.
Coming up.
Hey, you in the front. Come on, everybody. We need 10 people in here.
10 of us.
Get on his lap. Let the big guy up front. No, no, you gotta go in back. You're skinny. Oh, we could get one more. Hold on.
Find second gear in that thing, or we're gonna putter along.
All right. Dennis and Rob rode to Delhi in a tractor.
Put the coconut down, knees on the ground,
and rolled their way to a temple.
Yeah.
Now they finally reached the Delhi train station.
Hello, I need to get 2 tickets to Calcutta. Yes.
2.
Change.
Is this right?
Yes. 2 tickets to Calcutta. We're good. Happy journey.
All right.
Thank you.
2.
It's 900 miles from Delhi to the city of Calcutta, but the train doesn't depart for another 12 hours.
Hey, what do they do?
They are very good monkey dancing. So
come on, come over here. Come over here.
They have plenty of time to do what they do best.
Okay,
yes, sir? Yeah, I want to see the show.
Okay. Monkey around.
Hey, everybody get back. That is cool.
Michael Jackson dancing.
Watch out, watch out, watch out.
Damn.
Is he peeing down my back?
Are you gonna take him home, Dennis?
Come back.
Ow!
Yeah, jumping.
Yay!
This is a good little monkey show right here. I like this.
Thank you, sir. Yay!
Delhi streets were built to accommodate hand carts and pedestrians, not the heavy car traffic of today. But India's auto industry has found a way to clear up this traffic jam, the micro-sized Nano.
All right, get in. We could get at least 10 people in here. You don't think so?
Yes, we'll try.
The Nano features a 2-cylinder engine that puts out a mere 35 horsepower. It gets 65 miles per gallon. And it's yours for only $2,500. Amazingly, this Econo box seats 4 comfortably.
How do you open it? Hey, you in the front.
But Rob wants to push the envelope.
Come on, everybody, we need 10 people in here.
10 of us.
He wants to see if 10 little Indians will fit inside their Nano.
Get on his lap. Let the big guy up front. No, no, you gotta go in back. You're skinny.
All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 4, 5.
Get in his lap. 6, 7, 8, 9. Me makes 10.
There you go.
We could probably get 11.
If we had a kid, we could stick in the back window. 2 kids.
Hold on, I gotta get in the front here. Move over. Oh, we could get one more. Hold on.
Drive off.
Don't
Let's go!
Go, go, go!
Watch out where you're going!
I know, I know.
Oh, you're gonna try to find reverse now?
Oh my God.
What's going on, Jeremy?
We're packed in here like sardines. We're like pickled pig feet in here.
Tata, the company that manufactures the Nano, claims it's the next people's car. Now, the boys will try to prove it by moving these 11 people across town to their hotel.
Okay, find first gear.
Hey, what are you doing? What's the matter? Look where you're going.
We're carpooling. I mean, what the hell, man? We're trying to save.
Trying to be green and save the environment.
This is how y'all should do it over here.
High five. There it is. There it is. Yeah. You ever see 10 in one of these? We got 10.
Go, go, go.
What's not moving? The car's moving. Whoa! Okay, pull over.
Pull over.
Pull over here.
Pull over here.
My nuts are squished. Stop, stop, stop. That's a crowded way. Let me get that for you.
Jeez.
Thanks for the ride.
Thank you.
Dude, I was so squished in there.
The next morning, the guys hire a pair of rickshaws to take them to the train station for their trip from Delhi to Calcutta.
You're 50 years old and you've never been to a baseball game.
No, I've never cared for it, man. It just ain't, it's not my cup of tea.
But how do you know if you've never been?
They're in one of the most exotic places in the world. And what are they talking about?
You need to come to Boston, and I'll take you and your sons to a game at Fenway Park. I'm telling you, they will love it. What the hell is this? Look at this. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Stop down, stop down.
I don't have a clue.
Kachi Godai is one of the most famous dance forms in India and celebrates a group of legendary Rajasthani horsemen who stole from the rich and gave to the poor.
To have a race with these rickshaws, and the loser has to do that for an hour.
Let's do it.
We have to pull these guys.
Yeah, I'm gonna pull you. Oh yeah, we need to get off of this main road. I say let's run down this side street. We'll race down to the end of the street, and we'll turn around and come back.
This is a finish line right here.
Yeah, we'll have to wear that after the race. I'm gonna go get me a drink of water.
All right, when you get back, game's on.
All right. Hey, little buddy, how you doing, man? I'm gonna have a race with my buddy with one of those carts, one of those rickshaws. And you'll see me, I'm gonna be pulling one of them, and there's gonna be another guy with a hat on that says B on it. Okay, and I want you to take that stick, and I want you to cram it in the spoke and stop him, okay?
Tired of losing, Dennis is taking the gloves off for this one.
You have to stop him, all right?
It took going 3/4 of the way around the world with Mr. Reality for a little bit of Rob to rub off on Dennis.
Hey, Dennis, let's go! Come on!
I'm coming, hold on, get some water. All right, get in.
Yo.
Rickshaws originated in Japan around the end of the 19th century and quickly became a popular mode of transportation. They may seem archaic to you, but they're actually an improvement on the hand-carried litters that preceded them. In a city such as Delhi, where the most abundant resource is people, it's only natural for human-powered transportation to be one of the more dominant modes available.
Scoop!
Come on. Damn.
A test of speed soon becomes a test of strength.
Hey, 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 out of the way. Hey. Come on, Rob. Either speed up or let me around.
It's neck and neck, but Dennis's track is ready to spring. This leg of their India trip has seen a lot of Dennis versus Rob.
Either speed up or let me around.
Now the boys have turned a rickshaw ride into a race.
Come on, Rob. All right, dude, you're asking for it.
But with a little help. Dennis sticks it to Rob.
What are you kidding me? Woo! That's terrible! You all right?
I hurt my ankle. My ankle and my pride.
You can heal up.
No, no!
Get off of me.
The race is in the record books. Now the loser has to pay up.
Get it on, Rob.
That's messed up, and you know it.
No!
A bet's a bet. I lost.
All right, let's do it.
Come on, Rob.
This is so dumb.
If Rob's going to put on that horse costume, Dennis is going to make sure.
A scarf. Hold on, we need the mustache.
He looks like a horse's ass.
I'm trying to get him costumed up here, man. I want to draw the biggest crowd we can possibly draw. All right, right here, baby. Hey, yeah, 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 oh, yeah, hey, yeah, do some kind of something. Hey. Come on. Come on. Money, money. Get me some money. He's gonna go broke. He will absolutely go broke. Come on, you got an hour. I'm sure you'll get good at it.
He's hating it, dude. His ass is sweating.
Pony rides. Get your pony rides right here. All right. Hold on.
Oh, come on.
All right. Pony rides. Two for one. Two for one. Two for one. Hey. Pony rides. Uncle Rob's pony rides. Down trigger. Down trigger. Okay.
You look like a freaking fool, dude.
Dude, I feel like one.
You look like one.
Let's go.
They have a train to catch, right, and they want to make sure they snag some seats. The 900-mile trip from Delhi to Calcutta takes two long days. Trains are the lifeblood of India, with almost 40,000 miles of track. It's the fourth longest in the world and carries around 10 billion passengers annually, or around 27 million people a day. By contrast, trains in the U.S. only carry around 27 million passengers all year.
It's already full. How the hell is anybody else gonna get on it?
You gotta squeeze. Come on, come on, come with me.
All right, I got it, I'm with you. I'm gonna let some of them out of the way. Got a guy coming over with a sack of feed.
Come day.
This is the train to Calcutta?
Yeah.
To Calcutta?
Hold on.
Calcutta. This train?
Yeah.
Calcutta?
Huh.
Okay, thank you.
Calcutta.
What is this train? This is not a coal train like the last one.
No, it's an electric locomotive is what it is. We've done a steam train. We haven't done electric locomotive.
I remember the steam train. That's when I was shoveling the coal.
Yeah, baby.
This job is a pain in the ass, you know that?
These electric trains are really quiet, though. I mean, you hear a little bit of wheel beating on the tracks.
On trains such as this one, a device called a pantograph draws electricity from a contact wire suspended from an overhead support cable. The current is directed to a transformer inside the engine compartment, which converts the alternating current coming in to DC power for the train's motor.
Sean beats shoveling coal.
A primary advantage of electricity over coal or diesel is that it reduces pollution. With over 80% of all rail traffic in India being electric, we can all breathe a little easier.
So how about the monsoon fest? Is it, I mean, is it kind of like Mardi Gras or something like that?
It's a big party. They have floats in the streets, and it's dancing and singing. You guys been to the monsoon festival? It's a good time, yeah?
Very good.
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah, I don't even think you understand. Can't believe we're gonna pick up more people. Oh, we got two coming off, two going off, and one, two, three, four, five,
whoa,
six. We dropped four and picked up six, seven, eight in this one little hole. I'm glad my head's up here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look, we're packed into this train, and they're literally people on top of people. And I look over, and I see Dennis. He looks like Baby Huey sitting in there. He's like three Indian people crammed into one American body. And I'm like, oh my God, imagine if all the Americans lived in India. You'd have to have like three times as many trains.
Kind of smells like an old swamp with a trash dump close by and some armpit.
The armpit smells like, I think it's no. You.
No, it's not.
Check it out.
No, I'm good, I'm good.
Coming up.
Which way are we going? Are we going the right way now? Because we got to get up across that bridge.
Yeah, we got that panorama.
I don't know what he said.
Starting in Delhi, the guys added four new ways in their travel book, took on an overloaded tractor trailer,
go.
Got down and dirty as a couple of holy rollers, checked out India's automotive pride and joy, the Nano,
trying to be green and save the environment.
They raced a couple of rickshaws through the streets. Traveling through India has been an assault on the senses.
Kind of smells like an old swamp with a trash dump close by and some armpit.
Dennis and Rob have just spent 2 days on a crowded train going from Delhi to the city of Calcutta in eastern India. It's a way to travel they're happy to be done with.
It's like a stampede.
All right, all right.
Herding cattle, baby, herding cattle.
Oh my goodness, look at this place, it's a madhouse.
Dude, I'm so glad to get off of that thing. I want to get out of this cluster of people. I thought we were going somewhere, it was going to kind of spread out.
Stay with me. Back into it.
Somebody is running a hand in my pocket. This is too many people. It's steamy, it's hot, it's stinky, it's sweaty.
Excuse me.
Howrah Station is the busiest railway complex in India, servicing the country's four major trunk lines.
Calcutta Station. Where to?
This way.
Before it moved to New Delhi, Calcutta served as India's capital city and is the country's third most populous urban center.
As I could tell from the map, the river should be right out here.
Just outside the train station lies a tributary of the Ganges River, the last barrier between the boys and the monsoon festival.
This is the famous Ganges River. This is the lifeblood of India.
The Ganges is called the Mother of India, and its waters are believed to hold sacred powers that can rid bathers of their sins. The river used to be one of India's main transportation routes until railways took over in the mid-19th century. But take a dip in the Ganges and you're risking your life. The combination of raw sewage, ashes from cremations, and dead bodies cast into its waters makes the Ganges one of the top five most polluted rivers in the world.
Over there on the other side is a monsoon festival. All we gotta do is cross the river.
Well, that's easy enough, dude. You can go right here across the bridge, Rob.
No, it'll take us forever with all the traffic from all the taxis. We'll just get a boat.
Yeah, but you're crazy. Look at that current, dude. You cannot go straight across this river.
Dennis, it's gonna take us all day to go around the other way. We just rent one of these boats over here. We'll be across in 10 minutes.
Well, I'll tell you what. You go ahead. You take your little boat and go across. I'll go get me a cab, and I'll be waiting on the other side for you. I'll race you to the red building.
You're on. You see the steps where the people are bathing?
Yeah.
That's the finish line.
All right.
The loser has to call him Your Majesty.
All right.
The rest of the time, we're here in India.
Your Majesty. We've got a better idea. This time, the loser will give the winner the royal treatment at the monsoon festival.
Let's go.
All right.
I need a boat. Excuse me. I need a boat. I want to go across the river.
I'll tell you one thing. I'm not going to call him Your Majesty all week long.
Money. Come on.
All right. I got to get a cab.
Let's go. Ready? 500, yeah? Let's go.
Can you get me to the other side over here? I need to go on that bridge and go across to the other side.
I don't know English.
You're gonna have to go faster than this, guys. I'm never gonna win.
I wanna get a cab, you take me, I wanna go across this bridge and go to the other side.
Go upriver, that way when the current takes you, we'll land. I want to go right there. You see the steps? You see the steps? I want to go right there.
Yeah, it's on the other side of the water, and it's got a set of steps out there. It's telling me I got to go fast. I got to beat this up.
Come here.
All right, come on. What, 500?
Yeah, prepaid is 450, government. You pay you 50 extra. You're 500.
No, we don't want everybody in here. Just me and you and him.
Honor, Gari.
It's like everybody's taking a bath because it's Sunday. Everybody wash. The Ganges River is nasty. I mean, there's more fecal matter in this body of water than any other body of water on Earth. I know I wouldn't be swimming in there.
All right, let's go. Hey, we need to go as fast as we can, though. We got to go fast, like...
Yeah, fast.
Fast, yes.
Can we get another paddle? Excuse me, can I use your paddle? You have an extra paddle over there? Yeah, I'll pay you 100. Thank you. I'll just borrow it, I'll give it back. We're kind of in a race.
I just don't know about the exit to get on this bridge because it ain't like there's a road to jump right on. I think we have to go into this cluster of here in town. Which way are we going? Are we going the right way now? Because we got to get up across that bridge.
Yeah, yeah. Can't get that panorama.
I don't know what he said.
Let's do it. Let's go.
Rob and Dennis are racing across the Ganges to the steps of a bathhouse. The winner will be carted around like a king.
Excuse me. I need a boat.
Rob thinks rowing a boat will be faster.
I want to get a cab to take me. I want to go across this bridge to the other side. All right, let's go.
Dennis is betting on a taxi cab to get him there first.
Hey, which way are we going? Are we going the right way now? Because we got to get up across that bridge.
Yeah, yeah. Can't get that panorama.
I don't know what he said.
90,000 vehicles a day pass through the Vidyasagar Setu Bridge through 9 lanes of traffic. By comparison, there's only 60,000 vehicles on 6 lanes of traffic traveling over San Francisco's Golden Gate Bridge.
Come on, no coffee breaks. Let's go, guys. Oh, don't tell me Dennis was right.
Rob's having second thoughts about his chosen way to travel.
This current is a lot stronger than I thought. Here we are, I'm on the bridge.
while Dennis is cruising in his taxi.
All right, look, that's where I'm gonna go. See that red building right there? I gotta go there and wait for my buddy. Paco, step on it, baby. Get me to the waterfront. Take me right down there to that red building.
Let's put it in overdrive. Let's go, let's go.
Let's go.
Joe, Joe, if I have to listen to his mom for the rest of the time we're in India, I'll never forgive myself.
All right, where are we at? Where's the building at? This is it.
Dennis has another way to travel under his belt, but he's still lost.
Where's the building? Which way? Yeah. Which one? Down here?
Captain A-Rob continues to push his crew.
Come on, we're almost there. Come on. Home stretch.
Dennis is all turned around. What looked easy to find from across the river has become a needle in a Calcutta haystack.
I don't know which one of these buildings it is.
Rob lands exactly where he intended to, the winner's circle.
Let me pay my man. There you go. Thank you.
Hey, I'm looking for the big brick building, the red building with the steps down in front of it. You can see it from the other side. Is it this building right here?
Oh, Dennis will never learn.
It's got to be close because there's the bridge right there. Hey.
You guys know Dennis Anderson? He doesn't listen. Therefore, he will now call me Your Majesty for the rest of the day.
This is it.
Dennis! What are you doing?
I've been out front waiting for you.
Out front, my ass. You can't see out front from over there. That's where we came from.
I already came back here, and you weren't here, and
no,
I thought
you
meant the steps on the front.
No, you didn't.
Bull crap, dude.
Nice try.
I've been here for 10 or 15 minutes.
Call me Your Majesty, and stop lying, because I can always tell when you're lying because your lips are moving. What?
I was on the front of the building, okay?
Your Majesty?
No.
No? Yes. It was a close race, but you still lost.
After 7 new ways to travel.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
And a race across the Ganges.
It's getting ready to get thick down here, I can tell you that. The Monsoon Festival here is huge, man. It's kind of like a Mardi Gras.
The boys made it to the Monsoon Festival.
Get ready to have a party, because it is going down tonight.
It's time to let the good times roll.
Look at the ox, or the bulls.
We did that.
That is cool looking. I like that. Look at the wheels on that thing.
We did that same thing the other day.
Check out this spectrochrome wagon right here. Hey! Hey! I want to ride on something like that.
Chariots originated in Mesopotamia 5,000 years ago, but the basic design can be found in the historical records of numerous ancient cultures. Although the popular conception is their use in warfare, chariots were a common form of day-to-day transportation in the ancient world. So common that chariot forms the basis of the word car.
Dude, look at the float!
Coming around the bend is the main event. 3 human-powered chariots representing the gods Balarama, Subhadra, and Jagannatha.
Oh, they're pulling it! Check that out, dude. There's a tug rope hooked to it. All of these people lined up pulling this float, and that guy's steering it with that old ship wheel, the old wooden ship wheel.
Back.
Watch out. They're coming around the corner with the rope. Watch the rope. It's crazy.
It's kind of tight in here.
Look at this, dude. This thing's like a big Flintstone mobile. What is that?
Constructed from scratch every year, each chariot is over 40 feet tall and made of wood. The accuracy of the chariots is considered so important that only select carpenters may work on them. And the privilege is passed down from generation to generation.
See, if they roll that axle back and get their caster right on their kingpins, that thing would steer a lot easier. is lean forward like this, so when the wheels turn, they lay like a motor grader.
The car guy, Dennis, has some suggestions on how to improve upon the centuries-old chariot design.
This guy is fighting the steering wheel up here. He steers it. That's how he drives it.
Never mind all that. We got to get on one of those floats. Come on, Dennis. Dennis!
Dennis and Rob try to bag another way by jumping on a chariot.
No. Stop, stop.
I guess not.
If you can't ride one of their chariots...
Let's get on it! Let's get out!
Might as well ride one of your own.
Come on, hey.
Rob won the race. Hey.
Monsoon fast!
So Dennis makes good on the bet.
This is it, Dennis. This is what we've been waiting for.
I got it, Your Majesty. We're coming in here. I'm bringing it to the front. Yeah!
Here we go! The Monsoon Festival!
Monsoon Fest, buddy. I'm getting you to the front of the line right now.
Join the bridge!
A palanquin is a mobile platform primarily used to transport nobility, held aloft on the shoulders of the men carrying it. It's another purely human-powered mode of transportation and literally establishes the elevated status of the persons riding them.
We're at the Monsoon Festival, and I'm having a blast. I'm traveling in style.
Elevated status is Reality Rob's middle name.
What are you doing?
How about this, dude? Your Majesty, I got you into the Monsoon Fest.
Yeah.
Monsoon Festival. It rocks. Hey, say.
Hey, Dennis, isn't that our hotel up there? The Overoy Grand?
That's the Overoy Grand right there, buddy.
Have our guys pull in there when we get up close enough.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Thank you.
Hey, say. Hey. Underlay. Hey, say. Underlay. Hey, say. There you go, Your Majesty. Woo! Yay! Your Majesty.
The King stays at the Oberoi. Let's go.
The King and I.
Dennis and Rob came up with 8 new ways to travel on part 2 of their journey through India. They haul.
No.
They holy roll. They packed a nano.
We're trying to be green and save the environment.
They pulled. Spent too much time on an electric train.
Kind of smells like an armpit.
Dennis flagged a taxi.
We got to go fast, like.
While Rob floated his own boat.
Come on, no coffee breaks.
And His Majesty got carried away. The dynamic duo needs 19 more ways to get to that magic number.
The journey through India is quite amazing. I'm telling you, it's a culture shock for me. It's something I've never seen.
Dennis, what are you praying for?
That nobody sees me doing this.
So pretty much transportation in India is unlike anything else anywhere else in the world. Look, don't get me wrong. I love India. I love the Indian people. But the smells of India.
Look at that.
Have got to be some of the worst.
God, check out this electric train. It may hold 1,000 people. These people will put 3,000 people on it.
Kind of smells like an old swamp with a trash dump close by and some armpit.
And I was a part of it now because I wasn't smelling like no rose when I was over there neither. Check it out.
No.